Margins, vino what me. Margins Asian is called Andrea Rilko Foundation for Health and Social Justice. We work in Russia, and Russia is the only country in Europe with a rising rate of HIV. While most of the countries globally were able to control their epidemics, in Russia, 10 people get infected every hour. 100,000 new cases were registered just last year, and almost 32,000 people have died of AIDS. The main cause of death is tuberculosis, and 5 million people in Russia live with hepatitis. Are there any particular reasons for such a dramatic health crisis? It is not a result of bad faith or bad climate in my country. It is a direct result of the government's complete inaction, sabotage of public health, and refusal to provide effective prevention to people who need it most. People who inject drugs, sex workers, men who have sex with men. Instead of access to effective evidence-based HIV and TB drug treatment, what the government offers to people who use drugs is repression, mass incarceration, torture in public health and in law enforcement, and endless humiliation. Prisons are filled with people who use drugs. Over a fourth of all prisoners in Russia are punished for drug offenses, mostly for just using or possessing drugs. For people, 40% of women in prisons are there for drug use. For people whose immune status is weakened by drug dependence and HIV, imprisonment easily leads to TB infection and AIDS. So it effectively equals to death sentence. Prisons are not a solution for the health crisis. We need the government to support evidence-based, human rights-based programs in Russia, in Eastern Europe and Central Asia, all over the world. In Russia, effective and evidence-driven interventions such as opioid substitution therapy are still illegal. Needle and syringe programs are considered a threat to drug strategy of the country. And the organizations like my own that provide this life-saving services to people are labeled as foreign agents. We are not foreign agents. We are communities of people affected by HIV. We are people who lost their loves, who lost their friends and close ones to HIV. And despite the oppression of the criminal government, we will be providing life-saving services to people who need them most. We will never be able to achieve zero new infections if we don't put all our effort into achieving zero criminalization. And we will only be able to do so if we can shift the drug policy paradigm towards decriminalization of people who use drugs, legalization of drugs, and regulation of the drug markets. People who are in prisons for drug use and possession all over the world have to be freed and rehabilitated legally, socially, and economically. People cannot be criminalized for their behavior, sexual preferences, labor preferences, or what substances they choose to use. Today, I would like to support the key population networks from my region campaigning against criminalization. Protect freedom, dignity, and human rights of all affected by HIV. Chase the virus, not people!